My dad went through a midlife crisis once and started making trifles. Every night after school, he'd say, look at me trifle. I'd be like, that. You all right?
Well, the once I had sex with someone and somebody said I had a fanny like a smashed trifle.
I've seen your fanny. It's more like a fucking yawning hippo. Ripped out fireplace.
Like a punch lasagna.
Punch jacket potato. Chili con carne.
Chili con carne. Ooh.
Hi, everyone. My name is the Vivienne.
And I'm Baga Chipz. And we are
Queens Who Like To Watch.
Sex education.
Right, so it's a show. It's all about, I'd say, growing up in school. They're about 16, 17 years of age and all the trials and tribulations about coming out as gay, learning about sex, everything that goes along with growing up in school and learning about what to do with your cock and minge.
Yeah.
When I was in school, it was pretty pointless.
Oh, yeah, you don't know the gay sex.
I mean, having gay friends, obviously, I'm a natural woman. It's just things I've heard.
Put a condom on and don't get the bird pregnant.
Have you ever had a shag and you can't find a condom? I just use an empty Quavers packet.
I used a Tesco carrier bag the once.
Just don't use prawn cocktail, that stings.
Ooh. Lubricants.
My uncle used butter once. He did.
Oh, my God, I did use hand sanitizer the once. I used that as lube the once.
What?
On this bloke, he ran out the... oh, my God, he was like Tom and Jerry. He was like a cat on the roof. His arsehole was on fire, literally.
I'm not surprised.
It was like, ah, what the fuck's that?
Alcohol.
What the fuck's that up my arsehole? He had ring stingy. Oh, my God. He had to sit on a bag of frozen peas for about 3 weeks. God's on his drink. Cheers, love. Right, let's watch this.
So he's been sent to military school for sucking off a bully. No, he's the bully. Why would you send someone who's a habitual sucker offer to military schools?
In a room full of men?
A room full of dick.
Can you imagine me in the barracks at night all wanking off? Ooh.
Don't drop the soap, love.
Or do.
I just come to with them fellas screaming in my face.
And you have to do your beds and all that. I'll get my maids to do all my stuff.
Keep all your, what is it, your badges shiny?
Yeah, we've got 3 badges each off that RuPaul, so we'd have to keep them all clean.
Cheryl wouldn't know she'd born.
Yeah, Cheryl would be able to have a lie down. We'd have to have a big kick.
Picking on the gingers.
Yeah.
Terrible.
Oh, look, he's being nice
to
him.
Did you see what he did?
He's being nice to him. No. He wants his knob.
He made sure the hat fell by his feet, so he had to bend down and get his hat. Oh, he's having the time of his life at military school.
I was proper homesick when I first got here.
It's like the beginning of a bad porno, yeah. Isn't it?
Oh, God.
Like an old trigger movie. Remember them, White Van Man? If your perfect man walked through the door now in uniform, what uniform would it be?
Vicar. Yep.
My dad's a bit too. Like off your skin a bit. It's like the satin Hogwarts.
Yeah, it's like fucking Ron and Harry, look. Oh, look.
Oh, wait. What is this? This Netflix or bloody X-Tube?
Were they wanking each other off?
This is scandalous.
This is very degrading, this is.
Oh, what they found? Spliffs.
Oh, what is it? Marijuana?
Marijuana, what are you, me mum?
It's marijuana, I think. They're off to play a bit of Quidditch now, look.
They wanted to get me expelled because they're puffs.
Because they're wanking each...
Because they're what?
Puffs.
Puffs, ooh.
You've ever been called a puff?
No, not really, but...
That's just me. So far, they're having a spliff in the woods, they're bunking off lessons, they're noshing each other off and having a wank, so...
I might book a holiday, yeah. Lovely.
What were you like in school anyway? They've had to send you.
When I was in primary school, I used to bite all the kids. Yeah. I was also like Hannibal Lecter, I was like that.
I used to have all little size hustles. I used to sell DVDs.
DVD.
Out my locker. They refused to teach me physics. They threw a Bunsen burner at Jack Holmes's head. Bless
him.
So I used to go and sit in the library. We used to try and set fire to the library. So put that in.
Oh, that scared the fuck out of me.
I know, what's he doing?
Oh, look, he's giving him the eye.
Oh, yeah.
He's giving him the eye. Have you ever had anyone stalk you like that? I'm not being funny. I'd throw a bucket of piss water over him if they came on my front doorstep.
I have had stalky fans. I was at a meet and greet the other night. Some girl asked me to rip her tights and sign under the rip. No, that's not well.
Oh, I know what you mean, though. Oh, and this goes on his truth. I did a comedy tour, and... this bird came up to me and said, and she asked every queen, and they said, no, no, no. She asked me and I did it, spat in her mouth.
Oh, you filthy cow.
And I don't mean, I mean.
I've seen Nina West toes. Oh, they're at the fur.
Oh, I like his jacket.
I used to work on them. My family of travellers are.
Yeah.
I did it dressed as Cher once on the Hooker Duck.
He looks like he's done that fringe with a spoon.
That fringe is suspect.
He's going to have a lamb shank now, look. They're going to be covered in spunk at the back when it all drops off the back.
Red wig and a silver wank, well, I don't think.
But he's up front, that one. He's all timid, that one. He's like, oh, no, not me, I'm a virgin.
Yeah, because he's only been noshed off once. Is he out gay? Is he out homosexual?
What with that jacket, love? Bloody hell.
Well, you don't know. When was this set?
Goodbye.
Oh, I think it's more of a love story.
He's planting seeds, isn't he?
He'll be planting seeds in the next episode.
Oh, he's on his date, look.
Yeah. Well, where are they gone? The Chinese? Oh, gorgeous, look.
What kind of foods are they having?
Spotted dick. Oh, look how he's looking at him.
I know, it's a bit creepy.
My fanny would get 10 to the dozen if someone looked at me like that.
Oh, yeah, they've gone the arcade. We didn't even find out what food they've had.
He's going to get it in the slot.
Going to chuck some bowling balls down the alley. Oh, that's why I didn't want to do it, he's shies.
Looks like he's having a fit.
Like two squirrels in a kettle.
This is their first date.
Oh, they're going to get batters outside if they carry on like that.
Fucking
imagine. Falling down the pier.
Smashed it, honestly, you smashed it really.
Oh, turn it off. Oh, look, 5 minutes ago he was like, oh, no, I'm not doing that.
5 minutes ago he was accusing him of being a stalker.
And now he's like fucking Darcy Bustle doing the dancing. Look at him.
Is this going to go sick? Is he a murderer?
Do you guys know each other?
Yes, they do. They were going in for Johnny's.
Oh, bless him. He was on for a shag then. God, there's loads of gays there, though. I thought I was at a fucking Pride March. It's true. Went to a Chinese and didn't eat fuck all, because I didn't see him eat anything. So that was a waste of fucking money.
Well, that's it, because obviously one of them was bottoming. Yeah. You know you don't eat if
you're going to bottom. Well, $16.95 for all you can eat, so you're not going to fucking eat anything. You know what I mean? And I think he's going to get jealous because he wants a bit of bum fun as well. And at the end
I think someone's going to get killed.
Well, how did you come to that conclusion?
I've just got a feeling.
What, because they went on a date?
With gypsy bloods, I've got a feeling. Might be the gin, like. Sorry, T, for seeing this.
We said earlier, there's no fucking gin in this. It's a fucking half-cut.
Coming through the window, it's like scream. See, someone's gonna die.
You come in.
Are you coming?
You coming? You will be later. Yeah.
All over your face.
This is how I die.
See?
Like a devilish Spice Girl bus. It's a Spice Girl bus, isn't it?
What's he doing? Has he got a gun?
If he pulled a baseball,
no, I'd be out of there.
Girl, run! A fucking baseball bat in the middle of nowhere and he's just walked with a psycho who bullied him for years at school. You got more chance of platting piss than me doing that.
Oh, look, he's brought safety goggles. Oh, well, there you go.
Oh, well, he's dead.
That's taken the danger level down a bit,
Matt
hasn't
slit
it?
His throat, but at least he brought goggles.
Oh, well, he's not making a fucking trifle with that bowl, is he?
They're going to fall in love, then,
too. Oh, it's like a mix between Ghosts and Hook. Run home, Jack.
$4 million! $4 million! Couldn't break a fucking nail, never mind one of them, you know?
No, not that vase.
That vase was nice as well. I would have given him at least fucking 50p.
I like
for
the trifle bowl. Imagine that with a bit of cream and strawberries. Bit of jelly, flakes on the top. Oh, makes me hungry.
Oh, I love a nice 70s trifle.
Oh, ooh. The sun's come up. Flip a coin, who's going to the shop for ciggies? Remember that when you've been up for days in a party and you flip a coin, see who's going, well, I'm not going to the shop. I went last time. You do that walk of shame like that. Can I have a bottle of gin and 20 ciggies?
I'm kind of glad you're back.
Oh,
bet
you are.
Yeah, I bet you am, yeah. Double the cock, yeah. Oh, he's going to move in.
Feel the eyes go.
Very, very hot. Very hot.
Down. Oh, the light's
gone off. It's going to be the other end.
Oh, you wear a mucky
It's
going to
be the other end. Well, he's a bit... I'm not being funny, my love, but he's a bit of a slag.
I think the bomb with the baseball bat's all a bit more romantic. You know, like going for a Chinese and a dance mat. Imagine... Do you know what I mean? Imagine someone threw a stone at that window now and said, come on, bagger, and take you out into the dark. And you go, ooh, what's going on? Am I going to die? Am I going to get pregnant? You don't know.
Oh, but he's gorgeous, that one.
You need to sort that fringe out. It's been cut with a ruler.
Do you remember when somebody put a bowl on your head and just shaved around it?
Well, they're obviously not a bit bothered about public display of affection in school, are they?
Oh, at my school, I'd had me fucking head kicked in.
Well, they all know I was a big homo.
Yeah, but you know what I mean? It's one thing being an homo and there's one thing wanking someone off on the way to GCSE maths, you know what I mean? He's the town slaggy, is he? Shagging every fucker.
Like Bonnie Tyler, the village bike. He's got his bit of plate, look.
Turn around.
Turn around!
So you've decided not to ignore me anymore?
Just buying a bit of super glue for me, please.
I would like to be your boyfriend, really.
What is he going to be, an adulterer?
An adulterer. A horrible, horrible little bitch.
They think they're in fucking Gran Canaria.
I don't know where they are here, but I don't know any little village with the fucking plotted pants like that. Brilliant. I just think there's going to be murders here. I can see it.
He's got anger issues, and I think he's going to actually kill that person so we can have him.
So now you can see death.
Oh, yes, I can see death.
See, I can't have nothing.
I never was able to throw a fucking house party. I'd have a clip round the ear hole. He's looking for blood.
What did I tell you? Hide your fucking crockery, whoever house that is.
You see, I need to know how to douche.
If you're not ready to talk about douching with your boyfriend, you're definitely not ready to have this cock in your ass.
Ooh! Take that fucking hose head off, shove it up your ass and turn the hot water on. Yeah. Not too hot, though.
Have you ever douched?
Yes, love. You don't want to be shitting on people, do you? I'll tell you a good story.
I know what she's going to say.
One of my best friends, Sian. She said, girl, I was shagging this big drug dealer and he put it up me and I knew what had happened. So he pulled it out and all I could smell was shit. So I grabbed it, turned round, sucked it off. I thought, it's only a bit of dinner. Because she says if she'd have known, she'd have shit on his dick and she'd have battered him.
I'm scared.
If you can't love yourself, then you can't love anybody else. Can I get an amen?
And I think I'm bisexual.
If you can't love yourself, how the hell are you going to nosh him off? He's probably grown up as the fucking hard knock in school.
Yeah.
Last thing he wants to do is shout around about being a big bloody Mary.
Well, I was quite hard at school and I was gay. I was like a Von Atkins from Bad Girls, you know what I mean? I'd be like, I'll cut you up, bitch. And they'd be like, oh, fuck, she's a fucking nutter. She might be gay, but she's fucking nuts. True. Do you know what, though? It's true.
It's true. What is it?
Do you know what? It's true. True.
True. Oh, look, why is he keeping this broken glass? Listen, Annie Lennox, chill.
It's true, he's...
I think he needs to glue that together. Get on fucking Antiques Roadshow and get over it.
Like you're trying to be something that you're not.
You tell him, love.
It doesn't make you sparkle.
Oh, how lovely.
Isn't that nice?
Fair play.
I used to get a backhand round my mother.
Still playing the French horn.
Playing the French horn.
He'll be blowing the rusty trumpet later. Because it feels like jealousy. Do you know what? I'd shag that one, but he's got the sweetness in it.
It's going to be a lot of baggage, isn't it? He's going to go with Raheem. I think he should go with Raheem because he's bad news.
Oh, isn't this good?
Yeah.
I'm gripped.
Hasn't his mum got a lovely little waist? They look like
is that
money.
Shirley Ballas from Strictly? I thought it was Dorian from Birds of a Feather, but it's not her. It's someone else.
She looks like Shirley Valentine. Yeah, back to the woods.
Oh, he's gonna run to. He's gonna run to
me. No, I'm gonna cry. Oh. And hoping, and singing, and summer.
Ooh,
that's never a school play.
What fucking budget have they got? A school play. It looks like the Bastard Brit Awards.
Jesus Christ!
Look. It's like a fucking Galliano catwalk.
Move on.
Is that LaRue who sang that song, Going Out for the Kill?
I have something to say.
Eric, you owe me a tenner.
What the fucking hell, excuse me, is happening
here? It's happening here.
Eric F. Young.
Oh, he's going to come out. How
Eric
you...
F. Young, I have something to say to you.
Oh, I'm going to well up. I'm going to well up, mate.
I want to hold your hand.
Oh no. Who's he going to go with?
Yes.
Oh, you bastard. What an absolute... That poor lad, humiliated. But at least he's come out in front... He's come out in front of all them people.
I know, but he's also broke that poor lad's heart.
Yeah, and he's just fucking smiling about it.
Lovely to meet you, Adam.
Lovely to meet you. He's just been kicked out of school and military school, love.
About 5 minutes ago, he was shagging someone else, so you need to teach your son to not shag around like a little trollop. I wouldn't even... I'd punch him in the gob. What would you do?
Never mind, go for it. What's the matter with him? This poor lad's heartbroken.
I can hold your hand, but I'm not sure he can catch you.
Well, he can. He's noshed him off twice.
No, but he's in love, and when you have to go where your heart goes. He's in love with that person. He was just a date. He's got background with him.
Get yourself back on grinds, lad. There's plenty more cocks in the butchers.
Cocks in the butchers.
Oh. I mean, they're 16 years old.
Are they 16? You could have told me. I've been fucking... I've had a semi halfway through this.
Oh, you dirty bitch.
Yeah, they're 16. No, the actors ain't 16. Don't talk. They've got a fucking hairy chest.
Well, Bagger, I enjoyed that.
I bloody loved it. We had a little bit of a piss up, watching a bit of telly together. Absolutely amazing. I can't wait for next week.
That was Sex Education. Catch series 1 and 2 on Netflix now.
Yay!
Much better.